Hey, what's up, everybody? This is Charleston, and welcome you guys to another episode of the Dreamerspro Show, where we cover everything from sports, hot topics, classic debates, entertainment, where we give you guys a fresh perspective on things and how we see them. And in today's episode, the topic is, will the Clippers be unstoppable once, will they be unstoppable when Paul George finally gets back? So that's the topic I'm going to get into in today's video. But before we get into that, I want you guys to please make sure you go ahead and hit the like button, hit the subscribe button, and hit the notification bell to be notified whenever we drop our content. Also, be on the lookout for our Dreamerspro premium community that's on the way, and also be on the lookout for dreamerspro.com, which will be coming after that. So the Clippers this year have been one of the best teams in the NBA. Let's just face it. If we look at record wise, if we look at their standings right now in the Western Conference, because to me, I think the Western Conference is the tougher conference out of the two. They have an 18-8 record. Now they've lost three out of the last four games. They've won six out of the last 10 games, but they've had a pretty rough stretch in the last few games. But nevertheless, they've been one of the top teams in the NBA. Paul George has had a bounce back season. Let's just face it, right? If we go and look at his numbers the season prior, this was his first year with the Clippers. First of all, he was playing less minutes. He was playing about five less minutes. He was playing 29.6 minutes per game. He was scoring 21.5 points per game, which is not good. He only played 48 games last season. He shot 44% from the field, 41% from the three, which is good. He shot 87.5% from the free throw line. He got you 5.7 rebounds, 3.9 assists, and 1.4 steals. And we all know that in the playoffs, he was even worse because his numbers went down, his shooting percentages went down, and he just wasn't a good enough player last year. Last year, he came under a lot of criticism for his performance in the playoffs, justifiably, given the fact that he's given himself the moniker as playoff P. We certainly did not see that. There's been a lot of back and forth chirping between him and some other NBA players. And when he went on the All the Smoke podcast, he said, listen, guys, I had two shoulder surgeries last offseason, and I wasn't able to train. And apparently rhythm and training is a very big thing to NBA players. Even the guys that have been in the league for 10 plus years, they still need to get in their reps every offseason. And apparently this offseason, the guy was able to train, get his body back into the shape that he needed to be in, get his mind right. But and this season, he came in with a completely different focus, and he's on a revenge season. And he made it clear from the outset that, listen, I'm coming back to play and have a type of season that you guys are going to put some bloody respect on my name. And listen, Paul George has taken his game to the next level. I think he's having the best year of his career, to be quite honest with you. He's playing about 34 minutes a game, so you can see he's playing more minutes. But although his minutes have gone up, his efficiency has gone up through the roof. The guy's averaging 24.5 points per game, so he's averaging almost 4 points more than he did last season. He's shooting 50% from the field, 48% from the three. Think about that. 48 percentage points from the three-point line. He's shooting 90% from the free throw line. So he's having a 50-40-90 season, a legitimate 50-40-90 season. And the hardest numbers, I mean, all of these numbers are hard, right? But shooting 48% from the three is spectacular. He's getting the more rebounds this season. Last season, it was a 5.2. This year, he's getting 5.6. But his assists are even higher this season. Last season, he was getting them 3.9. Now he's getting them 5.5. Now, obviously, that has a lot to do with the offensive philosophy of Tyronn Lue with their ball movement and player movement. So that's there. But that's also a byproduct of his playmaking and decision making. And he's getting you 1.2 steals this season. So Paul George, in my opinion, has been one of the candidates for regular season MVP, although his name is not being mentioned. But really, no Clipper has been mentioned in the MVP discussion. Quite befuddling, but that's the NBA we currently live in, and we all know that there's some politics that are going on in the background that we're currently seeing. Now, he's leading his team. Think about this: Paul George is leading his team in assists, 3-point percentage, and free throw percentage. That's how good of a season the guy's having. However, the Clippers as a team have lost three out of the last five games that they played. They just got a win last night against the Timberwolves, but they lost three out of the last five games. And Paul George has not been available for the last three games, and he won't be available for the next game that they're going to play against the Chicago Bulls on Friday. And this is what they've missed in his absence. They've missed his defense because he's an all-world defender, all-first NBA defensive team type of player. They're missing his playmaking, which is obvious. They're missing his scoring. You just took out 25 points out of your offense. Last game he played, he hit 8 out of 9 threes for 36 points in that game. They're missing his clutch shooting, his timely shooting. He's been red hot for this team in the clutch this season. And also they're missing his floor spacing, right? Guys are not getting the same looks that they used to get earlier in the season when him and Kawhi Leonard were playing, right? The three-point percentages are going down. If you look at Nicholas Batum, it's a lot harder for him to get open looks because Paul George and these guys are not there to create spacing for him. So the team is missing quite a lot. Now, when he does play for the Clippers, they're a completely different team, right? They're a completely different team. And I believe that when Paul George comes back, the Clippers are going to go back to being one of the top two teams in the NBA. I think the two top teams, the top two teams in the NBA right now, or in general, are the Clippers and the Lakers. The Lakers are winning with Anthony Davis, without Anthony Davis. LeBron James is the leading candidate for MVP, in my opinion. If you look at the season that he's having at his age, at his advanced age of 36 years old, continually willing his team to wins. He's not really taking any nights off. He's chasing his legacy, right? But I think the Clippers and the Lakers are the top two teams in the NBA. They've played once. The Clippers got the best of them, but we're going to see when they play again. And I think these are the two best teams. But Paul George needs to be available, because when he comes back, number one, what that does is it allows all the other players to go back to their natural positions, right? Reggie Jackson goes back to the bench. He's not going to be getting so many minutes. Paul George will go back to the two. If Patrick Beverley's healthy, who came back last night and played a limited amount of minutes, he goes back to the one. Then you have Kawhi Leonard at the three, or I think Nicholas Batum at the four, if I'm not mistaken. I think he plays the four on most nights. And then you put Serge at the five. So I think everyone goes back to their natural positions, which helps their rotation. Secondly, Tyronn Lue staggers his two stars, right? So usually in the first quarter, I think they take Kawhi Leonard out at the 4 minute or 3 minute mark. They sit him. Paul George. Kawhi Leonard finishes out the first quarter, and then Paul George is back on the floor with that second unit. And he provides stability on the second unit with his playmaking and his shot making and all of these different things. So it allows their rotation to be a lot better because you have one of your best players on the floor at all times. And that's something he has not had over the last three games. And I still think, listen, when he comes back, the Clippers are going to be one of the top two teams. I think they still need to make one or two moves before the trade deadline, which I think they will, especially at the point guard position. And they may get another big, who knows. I think they need to make one or two more moves, and we'll see what these guys end up doing with Lawrence Frank and these guys, with the management of the Clippers. But for me, I think once he comes back, the Clippers will be unstoppable, to be honest with you. And unstoppable in the sense that they become one of the top two best teams in the NBA. For me, I still think it's the Clippers and the Lakers. I think these are the two top teams in the NBA. Now, some people are going to say the Utah Jazz. And the Utah Jazz, we have a kind of wait and see approach. But similarly with the Clippers, because the Clippers, a lot of us are waiting to see how they're going to perform in the playoffs. Lakers are going to get the benefit of the doubt because they just did it. They just won the NBA title. So everyone is going to give them the benefit of the doubt, as they should. Although Skip Bayless calls their ring the cubic zirconium ring because he felt like, you know, that was the cheapest ring you could ever get. But nevertheless, they got their ring. But this year, I think once Paul George is back, this team will be back to being unstoppable, and they'll be firing on all cylinders. Not to say they can't lose games. Obviously, anyone could lose a game. But I think they'll be much better than they are now. So what I want to know from you guys is, do you think that when Paul George comes back, the Clippers will be unstoppable? Or do you think, listen, you don't think it's going to make a difference either way? Whatever you guys think, please leave your thoughts and comments in the comment section below. Again, if you enjoy the video, be sure to make sure you go ahead and hit the like button, hit the subscribe button, and hit the notification bell to be notified whenever we drop our content. Again, if you enjoy this video, be sure to check out the next video that we have coming up. Once again, this is Charles here from Dreamerspro, wishing you guys an amazing day, and catch you guys on the next episode. Peace.